Morning, everybody. Oisin here, back with another video. So it's Monday morning here. A beautiful day as well. And I'm going to do a wee bit of training here, but I think probably the topic of today's kind of video or vlog is going to be training around injuries. I picked up a back injury there the other day doing a bit of squatting. It's like I've had issues with my back before, and it's something's persisted with me for a while, and it cleared up, and then I went and ruined it again. So it's something I'm going to have to train around now, but I think it's something that people tend to be a bit confused about. I get asked a lot about training around injuries, so I'm going to do a wee session here, and then we'll maybe chat a bit more about it later on. So yeah, let's get some training done. So, landmine variations of pressing on your own can be really good. Quite natural movements, especially for shoulder pressing. If you have any shoulder issues, it can be a good one. I like doing this kind of half kneeling one as well, because you get a good bit of core engagement from the stability. But yeah, a good alternative to normal pressing or normal rowing. I was in Belfast last night. I'm just down there today, straight back into work. So I'm not going too hard on anything today, because not feeling too good. I'm actually not too bad, to be fair. But trying to do a wee bit in here just to sweat a bit of drink out of me. But nice being able to get up and go out, meet up with some friends, got some nice food, bootleggers in Belfast, good burger. But it's nice being able to do them. I think something I'm trying to do a bit more now is try and make a bit of time to have a bit of a life rather than just working here all the time. I do love it, but sometimes you need a break. This bike came with a heart rate monitor watch. So it's actually pretty cool. You can see the heart rate on this display. This has actually so far been a really good bike. It seems to be pretty much the exact same as the Assault air bike version, so pretty good. But what do you see how high this goes up there? 3, 2, 1. How's it going? How's it going, everyone? It is Tuesday, and it's just gone, it's coming to about 6 a.m. now, so getting ready for the first group session here, and then a couple of clients after that there. A little bit of free time in the middle of the day here, but yeah, gonna go in here, get set up, and then we'll probably try and do a wee bit of training, and I'm going to talk you through kind of training around injuries. Didn't get a chance yesterday, so we'll get a chance. So one of the biggest difficulties I'm kind of getting at the minute is trying to find time in the day. Things are going really good here in the gym and it's busy, but it does mean that that's a lot more hours of your day. So you're like trying to account for every single hour, like, and every single hour is nearly filled up with something. So I'm sitting thinking here, like, I've got this YouTube video to edit. I've got like programs to sort. I've got promos for like the online program to sort in the next while. Things in the gym to prepare. And you're sitting thinking, I've actually got every single hour filled up here today nearly. And that's one of the biggest things, is trying to win back a bit of time. And I would definitely say to anyone that is thinking of getting into this kind of industry and personal training, it's tough. Like, you know, timing, trying to find time in the day to do all this shit is difficult, and trying to make time is tough, because, you know, if you take time away one day, it really messes you up the next day. But it's all part of it, I suppose, and it's all part of the process. But yeah, still just in between clients here today, just waiting on one of the lads to come here. And today, going for a bit of lunch here, and I'm going to try and see if I can get time to train. You see, this is the other issue, trying to find time to train, but I might try and squeeze in even half an hour or something. It's better than nothing. So yeah, that's a day done there. I was working there today just, and then we had training there tonight. Not too much content, it's, to be honest, I was just a wee bit lazy on it, didn't probably video as much as I should have, but it is, it's hard remembering, first of all, and then hard just having the energy sometimes to do the stuff, to get the videos. But yeah, I just want to chat a wee bit about training around injuries. I picked up an injury on the back the other day, it just kind of made me think about training around injuries. But it was a lower back injury for me, but it kind of meant that you could still do quite a lot of other training. You could even do some back training. You know, it's just all about how you can alter your training. And I think all too often people will get an injury and just stop altogether. I get that question a lot on Instagram Q&As about, you know, I've hurt my ankle, how do I keep my fitness up? And it's like, you know, does it hurt your ankle if you cycle? If not, then maybe do some cycling. Does it hurt it if you walk? No, then do some walking. And I think that's generally the best way to train around injuries is, you know, if the movement you're doing doesn't hurt you, then you can probably batter away with it. And there's loads of movements that, you know, you can do for different body parts that probably won't hurt it if you picked up an injury. Like, you know, yes, I've hurt my back, but it's a lower back, so I can still do rowing movements, can still do chin-ups. What I can't do, though, is probably deadlifts or anything that's putting me in the, like, a hinge position at the hips. It's kind of common sense, just applies, like, and, you know, don't do the movement that originally hurt it in the first place. It seems kind of straightforward, but I think sometimes people get injured and just stop altogether and then go straight back into it and then wonder why they're getting injured again. You know, so, I don't know if that made much sense, but I just feel it's something that I keep answering a lot in Q&As is how do you get around injuries and stuff. And the best way to do it is use your common sense, you know, try and train the other body parts that you have. You've probably quite a few more. Avoid movements that hurt it and look for movements that don't hurt it and just do them. Don't know if that helps or what, but a bit of information or a bit of something anyway there. But yeah, hopefully have a bit more content over the next couple of days with videos and stuff. Sometimes it's hard trying to get stuff all the time, trying to be consistent with these here. But as I say, it's hard when you're busy, but I do want to do it. So yeah, I'll see you in the next one, okay? Tomorrow, that's the plan anyway. So see you then.